the grave. They could not. For Jesus Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Hallelujah. Hearing that good news of the resurrection in this time of sheltering in place, we may be weary and in need of that strong word and good word of hope. We thank you for joining us today in our worship. We are going to begin our worship service with a thanksgiving for baptism. You may wish to try this at home, perhaps when you're washing your hands or when you're preparing a meal. You may get a small bowl of water, and place it, get a pitcher of water, and you need not use the words I use, but something to their effect. As we remember that we are washed clean in the water of baptism, and we have died and we have risen again with Christ. Joined in the waters of baptism, we are raised with Jesus to new life. Let us give thanks for the gift of baptism. We give you thanks, O God, for in the beginning you created us in your image and planted in us a well-watered garden. In the desert, you promised pools of water for the parched. And you gave us water from the rock. When we did not know the way, you sent the Good Shepherd to lead us to still waters. At the cross, you watered us from Jesus' wounded side. And on this day, you shower us again with the water of life. We praise you for your salvation through water, for the water in this font, and for all water everywhere. Bathe us in your forgiveness, grace, and love. Satisfy the thirsty and give us the abundant life only you can give. To you be given honor and praise through Jesus Christ our Lord in the unity of the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. How is it with your spirit today? Be reminded that God is for you. Jesus is with you, and the Spirit is within you to help you weather all storms. I know for me, my spirit tends to be in lots of places. As I left my home this afternoon, I was still living in Good Friday. On the way here, I reflected upon Holy Saturday and how that is really how we are living right now. In the meantime, as we wait for the release, the good news that we are free to return to some normalcy of life. But in the meantime, we live in hope and we trust that as surely as Jesus rose from the dead, we are promised new life and resurrection too, now and forever. We continue by singing, Jesus Christ is Risen. If you have a hymnal at home, turn to 365.
Thank you.
your people toward the fullness of eternal life with you. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. We continue with the reading assigned for today, Psalm 118.
This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Give thanks to the Lord, for the Lord is good. His mercy endures forever. Let Israel now declare, God's mercy endures forever. The Lord is my strength and my song, and has become my salvation. Songs of rejoicing and salvation echo in the tents of the righteous. The right hand of the Lord acts valiantly. The right hand of the Lord is exalted. The right hand of the Lord acts valiantly. I shall not die, but live, and declare the works of the Lord. The Lord indeed punished me sorely, but did not hand me over to death. Open for me the gates of righteousness. I will enter them and give thanks to the Lord. This is the gate of the Lord. Here the righteous may enter. I give thanks to you, for you have answered me, and you have become my salvation. The stone the builders rejected has become the chief cornerstone. By the Lord has this been done. It is marvelous in our eyes. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it.
Do not fear, he said. You are looking for 2,000 years ago, not just to think that resurrection was only 2,000 years ago and doesn't happen today, but rather that we are called to witness the resurrection, to witness Jesus on the loose, out and about, going ahead of us, preparing the way for love and hope and peace. And then we are to witness to it and to share that good news. Instead of hiding away in fear, instead of just sharing that news when we are able to gather together in a worship space, but rather sharing that word of hope and love in all places, in our homes, in our workplaces. I think Mark is challenging us, encouraging us to be witnesses, to go ahead out to Galilee and find resurrection at work, God at work still today. In Romans, it tells us that God can work through all suffering for those who have faith. God can work good through all suffering for those who have faith. Paul doesn't say we will have no suffering. Jesus suffered on the cross to show us that indeed life is full of suffering. But amidst that suffering was beauty and hope and resurrection. They go together. So often we think we can't lament and be grateful at the same time, but the Psalms tell us a different story. We think we can't be sad and full of joy at the same time, but those who have lived through grief know that you can weep and laugh within a short amount of time. We can feel afraid and also trust and be confident that God will carry us through and that God has gone ahead of us. Jesus has gone ahead of us and knows the dream of where we will come from this for those who have faith. So I would like to suggest something to you. I received in the mail yesterday an invitation. And I'll share it as we go out today. But an invitation for Easter Sunday to go outside your front door any time of the day and simply shout, "Jesus Christ has risen. He is risen indeed." That meant a lot to me, that invitation to the resurrection. I wonder what it would be like if we made little signs and put them in the places we go or in our yard that say Galilee and remind ourselves that Jesus said, "I will go ahead of you to Galilee." Remember, Galilee is where Jesus did most of his ministry, most of his teaching, most of his healing, most of his sharing the good news was in Galilee, not the big city of Jerusalem. So where is our Galilee? Maybe if we put a signboard out in front of our home, sometimes like people put house for sale, we put Galilee. And we know that Jesus is there ahead of us. Or at clinics, at hospitals, at grocery stores. All those places that are so necessary for us, Jesus is there too. And what if we took that sign and went to those places and shared a story on our own phone? Instead of a selfie, we told a resurrection story. We said, "Jesus is at work Jesus Christ has risen today. Alleluia. Amen. We now continue by confessing our faith with the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again and ascended into heaven. And he is seated at the right hand of the Father and will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Receive the offer of music that will be played for us, hymn number 367 and 361. While you receive this offer of music, you are encouraged to consider how you might share your gifts, how you might share the love of Jesus and the hope of the resurrection, and how you might continue to sustain the ministry of Scandian Grove Lutheran Church with your financial contributions. Thank you for all the gifts you are sharing in God's world. invite you to take a deep breath in, breathing in faith, and breathing out all that separates you from trusting in the good news. Praise be the nurses and doctors, every medical staff bent over flesh to offer care, for lives saved special things